हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम रज़ा मसूद। टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट अ टॉपिक, हर्ट्ज़बर्ग्स टू फैक्टर थ्योरी। फ्रेंड, दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड बेसिकली इट्स अ मोटिवेशनल थ्योरी एंड वी विल सी दिस टॉपिक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट टुडे। फ्रेंड, इफ यू आर अ प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर एंड वर्किंग इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑलरेडी और इफ यू आर प्लानिंग टू गिव एग्जाम ऑफ PMP और स्टडिंग प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट इन यूनिवर्सिटी, so friend let me tell you that this is a very important topic and you will see this topic in the exam and at least few questions, at least 3 to 4 questions you will see definitely which are directly related to this topic. Also friend, if you are a professional project manager and working in any organization, so again this topic is very important, that what is Hertzberg's two factor theory, what is motivational theory and how we can motivate the people to achieve something. So this is very important topic today. So friend, let's start. First of all, I would request to please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell option as well so that my new videos can reach to you. So let's start. Hertzberg's two factor theory. First of all friend, try to understand that two factor theory is a motivational theory. Okay, so it's a theory which talks about motivation. So first of all, before going forward, we have to understand that what is motivation. Okay, what does it mean by a motivation? Friend, motivation is a state of mind filled with energy and enthusiasm which drives a person to work in a certain way to achieve desired goals. Friend, motivation is a positive energy which pushes you, which gives you energy to move forward, to achieve something, to achieve some goal and objective or aim. That is called as motivation. For example, if you have seen a cricket match, you have definitely seen a cricket match. When a cricket match is starting, the captain of the team is standing in the ground and he is talking with the team. Actually, what he is doing at that moment when the match is going to start, basically he is motivating the team. He is trying to push the team to achieve something, to defeat the other team. What is the objective? Objective is to defeat the team, other opponent. Similarly friend, you may have seen that any political leader is talking with the team, is speaking. He is speaking on some radio or television and he is motivating the team towards some particular goal, some objective. So what is the purpose of a speech at TV or radio? What is the purpose of a speech? What he wants to do? Basically the leader wants to motivate the team member. Motivation means he wants to give the positive energy to the team members, to the employees, to the nation, so that they can convince and they can move towards some positive, some objective, some goal. Nowadays you have definitely on the YouTube or some other social media, there are nowadays motivational speakers are very popular nowadays. I'm sure that you have seen the videos, several videos of motivational speakers. What actually motivational speakers do? Motivational speakers gives you the positive energy, positive vibes, and they motivates you to achieve something, to achieve something in your life, in your professional career, in your life. So basically what does it mean by motivation? Motivation gives you the positive energy to achieve something. However friend, on the other hand, the other side of the coin is that the demotivation. Demotivation means the totally opposite sense of motivation. That means that you are not demotivated, you have negative vibes, you don't want to achieve something, you are not willing to do something. So friend, like motivation is the constructive energy or the positive energy which pushes you towards to achieve something. Similarly, the demotivation is the destructive approach or the negative approach which basically destroy something, which destroy anything. If the team, if you are working in any organization and for example you are implementing some project and your team is demotivated, so that simply means that you are going towards a failure. Because if the team is demotivated, they are not willing to do something, anything, so obviously the result will be failure. So friend, this is very, very important that the team should be motivated to do something, right? Remember one thing, if you are a practical manager, if you are a professional project manager and you are implementing any project, so remember one thing, that it is very, very necessary that the team through which you are working, it should be totally motivated. If they are not motivated, so remember one thing, that you are going towards a failure. Now we will talk about Hertzberg's two-factor theory. Friend, basically we are now right now talking that what are the motivational factors through which teams motivated. Friend, as per the Hertzberg's two-factor theory, there are mainly two factors that an organization can adjust to influence motivation in the workplace. First one is the motivator and the second one is the hygiene factor. Okay, as you seen from the name of the theory, two-factor theory, two factors are there. One is motivator and the second one is hygiene factor. Motivator means that the factors which encourage the employee to work hard, okay, and the second one is that which basically doesn't encourage employees to work hard, but they will cause them to become unmotivated if they are not present. Okay, so the two factor theory basically talks about two factors. One is motivation and the second one is hygiene factor. Motivation means, friend, just an example, the factor which motivates the people. For example, motivation factor is that if you complete a project on time, you will get an reward, okay, you will get an appraisal, you will get the appreciation certificate from the senior management. So these are the motivational factor. Okay, hygiene factor, what is hygiene factor? Hygiene factor is that the sitting arrangement should be clean. Simply, very simple example. For example, if you are working in any or IT organization or software house, the AC should be available, air condition should be available in the room. See, if you talk about hygiene factor, these factor does not motivates the team, okay, but if they are not available, the team will become demotivated. What does it mean? For example, if the air condition is not available in the IT industry, in the software house, so people will become demotivated. So remember one thing, that these factors like for example air condition or some other factor like that, so these factor does not motivate the team, but if these factor does not available, the team become demotivated. Okay, so two factor theory talks about two factors, motivation and hygiene factor. Motivation, the factor which encourages the people, which gives the positive energy, which motivates the people, and the other factor is hygiene factor, which does not motivate the team, but if these factors are not available, so it will demotivate the team. So these are the two factors which Hertzberg's theory of two factor talks about. Now just give you a simple example of motivation and hygiene factor. Motivational factors are like, for example, achievement, recognition, work itself, responsibility, advancement, growth. Like for example, at the end of the year, at the time of appraisal, if you work hard, you will get an appraisal, you will get promotion, you will get raise in the salary, you can become the head of the department, you can lead the team, you will get advancement, you will get responsibility, more responsibility. So these are the factors which we call as motivation, like something achievement, some recognition. So these are the motivational factors which are very important. So these are the factor basically which gives a positive energy to the employee, and he will work more hard. Okay, he will give more his efforts. So these are the motivational factor. On the other hand, the other factors are hygiene factor. These factors are not motivational factor for employee, but if these factors are not available, so these factors will demotivate the team. What are those factors? Simple example, like company policies, supervisions, relationships, work conditions, remuneration, salary, security. For example, friend, if the supervision is not good, like for example, you don't have the good relationships with the boss. So these factors basically demotivates you, and the end result is that you will not give your 100%, you will not adjust in the environment. Job security is a very, very important factor of hygiene factor. Like for example, if the job security is there, like for example, our overall security is there in the organization, so it is very important factor for with respect to hygiene. So friend, that's all for my side. Just remember that these are the two factor, motivation and hygiene. Motivation is the positive energy which motivates the people, and hygiene factor is the factor that are important for an employee, but it will not motivate the employee. However, if these factors are not available, it will demotivate the employee. So friend, that's all from my side. I have tried my level best to explain you the concept of the two factor theory. Remember one thing, friend, that with respect to professional life, these factors are very, very important to understand and implement in your professional life, and to understand in your professional life. So friend, that's all from my side. I hope you like this video. If you like, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and thank you. Thanks a lot for your time, and that's all from my side. Thank you.